How it all started was I got a phone call from Rod Bush. He's like, we'll take you to Nationals and help you out and everything else. And I was so pumped, and I was, you know, he said, we'll talk about more logistics later. And we talked again, and I asked for like the moon, you know, I asked for everything. And he told me one day, he's like, you can never make a full-time living racing dirt bikes, just remember that. And I think it was probably another, you know, after a few championships later on down the road, a couple years later, he had mentioned that that he remembered telling me that, and that I was making a pretty good living and living at home and all that kind of stuff. But that's how it all started. It was pretty much by Rod just making a phone call, and like I say, Alan got a hold of him, and they kind of seen a future maybe and said, hey, we'll give this kid a chance. And you know, that started in 95. I was 10th, 96. I think I got 5th, and then I won my first championship in 97.
When this all first came about, when the, you know, Husqvarna, Husqvarna, KTM thing in the middle of the year started materializing, we all kind of got together and started thinking about, you know, where I kind of fit into this whole thing. And at that time is when I was thinking about, man, I, you know, it's going to be 20 years, and I want to say that I'm done, you know, right around there. And for me to go back to KTM on my final year kind of made sense for everything. So that's where, you know, talking with everyone at KTM and then me coming to grips with myself saying, hey, yeah, I'm going to be done at 20. I'm actually, at first I was a little bummed, and then, you know, just thinking about it, that it's the end. But now I'm, you know, more excited than anything. Yeah, I still got a little bit of, you know, emotions about it and everything, but that it's going to be done. But I'd much rather have this knowing it's going to be my final year than to finish out a year going, okay, you know what, I can't put anything together, and Roger getting hard these days to come, you know, to come up with. So for me to have this opportunity with KTM and to say it's my last year is unbelievable. You know, it's come around in full circle, and it's great, and I'm, you know, extremely fortunate to have this opportunity with KTM.
Mike Lafferty is just one of those racers that never says die. You know, he's always going to be there at the end of the race, and usually comes on strong at the beginning of it too.
A real good memory from we were in Bellingham, Washington, and he was happy because he had put a bike together for me to go riding with him, and that's one of the special things that we always had, is since I was a previous racer, that we could go riding together and enjoy and really understand what he was talking about, since we would ride together.
I remember Al telling me, like, man, you can win this. And for me then, it was, you know, just to comprehend that was extremely, you know, like, you know, I don't think I realized it then, but it's like, yeah, I don't care about that. I just want to win. I want to win the next one. I want to win the next one. I want to win, you know. I think we won six or seven races out of that year when there was, you know, 10 or 11. So for me, that was huge. Once the ball started rolling, I just wanted to keep winning, and the championships fell into it. Next thing I know, we won our first championship, and I'm thinking, holy smokes, you know, what just happened? I couldn't have any better people than Al and Melissa helping me through those times of, you know, always telling me, just ride your bike, just ride your bike. That's all you gotta do is just ride your bike. We'll take care of everything else. Once that all kind of started, and I kind of had the right people around me, and I was hungry to win, that's all I wanted to do, is just keep winning, keep keep racing. And that's where we strung along, you know, a lot of wins. We had a lot of injuries, had a lot of places, you know, I wish I could have won, I didn't, but we could always pull it together, it seemed like, and rebound really well. And you know, I tied a bunch of wins together, and we missed a couple years, but come up with 8 championships was always something. I never could even imagine that I could get one, you know, to start off with a win, let alone a championship. So to string along 8's been, you know, it's been really awesome.
And when I think about Mike, you know, Mike is probably what every racer wants to be. He's as good on the bike as he is off the bike, which is a rare quality. And, you know, his commitment to the sport and growing the sport, and he's just a good guy. And that's tough to find in a racer, somebody that's that competitive and willing to win, but yet still will, you know, talk to the public and do any project you ask him to do.
I think the thing I miss the most is the feeling of winning. You know, I haven't done that in a while, and that's what I strive to do right now. Why I do this and why we all do it is because we all like to ride dirt bikes. I'd love to ride my dirt bike, but I love to win. And I think I had that feeling for a while, and I thrived off of that for a lot of years. And I'm going to miss that, I think, more than anything.
He's like my son, you know? everybody, you know, for a while, once in a while, they would call him my son, but I could never measure up to his mother, Madeline. She's a wonderful lady, but it's just, it's been an honor. It's been a joy. It's a journey that I wouldn't trade for the world.
The people I want to thank that I've worked with and I've kind of met, the list is unbelievably long. I know I'm going to forget somebody, but from the back in the day with Al, Melissa, to that's my family in racing, to my family at home, everybody, my team managers I had first, probably everybody at KTM, everybody I've met at all the races, all the friends I've made in this whole time. I don't want to say goodbye. You know what? So many people that I couldn't even imagine not doing this or being where I am today without knowing them, or that's where this whole thing comes together. It's kind of a family, and it's kind of been my whole life.